I could just sit here and stare out into this, like, horizon all day. I mean, it is so pretty. You got, you know, the details of the walls. You have the fish that are jumping in the waterfall down there, apparently. I don't know how they managed to survive not falling, but hey, whatever. It's just so nice. So, so cool. What's going on, everyone? MetalBlade427 here, and I welcome you back to Skies of Arcadia Legends for the GameCube. In the last episode, we made it here to Yafutoma, and we went around to, like, all of the different sections of it. I mean, there was some way up there and everything. And we went ahead and we got some new equipment, we got some new items, we got some new parts for our ship, we got some new crew members, we got a moonfish, we got a champ, and we got to know the people a little bit better. Found out that in their great sacred mountain of Mount Kazai, which, of course, you know, Mount Kazai is based off of Mount Fuji in Japan, a stratovolcano, I believe it's called, which is pretty much a active volcano that is jutting through the top of the clouds, which, you know, Kazai does the same thing here. It's just huge. Yeah, so it is definitely based off of that. And the Magasphere, as they call it, which is the Great Blue Crystal, is located down there. So we need to go into the shop, the ship shop here. And if you notice, there's like this thing standing over here. This suit. Restrained suit of armor. I wonder if they have... It's not a suit of armor of ice. It's a dive suit. Yes, my friend, today we go and do the water dungeon of Skies of Arcadia Legends, or just Eternal Arcadia, Skies of Arcadia. The dungeon was the same regardless. Oh my god, this is gonna be insane. This is gonna be a tough one. Well, it's not really that tough. It's just more of obnoxious. Yes, that would be the word I choose to use. So let's talk to this guy. Did I go to there? Buy some ship parts and in already. Let us proceed to Mount Kazai. Then let's get going to Mount Kazai. I'll get the ship underway so you guys can just sit back and take it easy. Oops, I almost forgot. If we're gonna go inside Mount Kazai, well, I don't know why he says we're, because he's not coming with us. I'd prefer to take these along and receive the underwater suit. Deep inside Mount Kazai is a cavern, and in some places there will be water. This underwater suit should come in handy. What? We have to go underwater? But I can't swim! Ah, do not worry. As long as you're using the underwater suit, you should be fine. Just be sure to breathe normally. Well then, shall we get going? Make way for Mount Kazai. Alright, here we go. And away. This is all automatic. I can't actually fly this ship, and nor are we gonna get onto or into any battles. But yeah, as you can see from here, it's huge. Now, it's weird, because the king or the lord, Mikado, told us that there's no way into here, but that's definitely an entrance. That is definitely a way to get into the mountain right there in that little hole that we were in front of. In fact, this looks like a very convenient landing spot. Wow, the water here is so calm. It looks like glass. It's hard to imagine that this was a volcanic area covered in lava at one time. What is that thing? What? It looks like a huge bird! That must be Blueheim. Blueheim? Yes, Blueheim was the Blue Gigas. It looks like Blueheim was trapped in the lava and encased in stone. If that thing ever got free, we'd be in trouble. The Gigas you've faced so far couldn't fly. I couldn't imagine how tough this one would be. We should secure the blue crystal as soon as we can. Let's go! Yeah, we definitely don't want to have to worry about the big old bird that's hanging up against the wall over there. If you wanted to get back to Yafutoma for some reason, you can always talk to this guy and he will get you there. Of course, save point if you need it. And otherwise that, let's go on into Mount Kazai. Music is actually the same as you get from the Great Silver Shrine, which is, I'm okay with that. I mean, the Silver Shrine had a lot of, like, watery elements to it anyway, so it kind of fits. Let's jump on this rope. Slide on down. And, yeah. Lucky for us, we really don't have to climb up that again, but, you know, if you had to, then, it would just be the squeaky sound. And this is pretty much your introduction to how the water mechanic works. anytime you get into like these pathways that lead underwater, it's just automatically done for you. And Vice puts on the suit, and everyone just kind of follows, you know, together with that. As you can see, you move so slow underwater. It's like, hop, 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 hop. The positive point of being underwater, though, no random battles. You can walk around all day to your heart's content, and you will not actually get into any fights with enemies. However, the moment that you come out of the water, that picks up once again. So let me put on the map so I can kind of figure out where the hell I'm going. Make our way down this way, and we come to the main chamber. Now, you come over here and you kind of figure out what the hell is it that you have to do. You kind of see a thingy over there. You have, oh yeah, that's right, there's the moonfish up that way. Okay, before I actually get into that, kind of forgot before I got into here and everything. There are two chests here in Mount Kazai, and you'll be able to get one moonfish and one champ. So keep an eye out on all those. You already saw where the moonfish was. It was way up there, but it's going to be a while before we get it. But if you look down in this, like, pit, there's water all the way down there, and that's actually where we need to go. We need to go down that way. So in typical water, like, levels fashion, we need to push a button. Like this. And from some random point in the dungeon, it starts to fill up with water. So, it went up that high. Probably have to push, four of them or so. Looks like it triggered some sort of water release valve. Ah, I see. The switch is probably here to fill this area with water. Yeah, you figure there's about four of them that you have to do, because if you get into a battle... Hang on a second. I mean, we're going to be going through this, because I know it's a new enemy. Hopefully it'll be a few new enemies, so I don't have to deal with them a little bit later. Nope, one new enemy altogether, and they're not even looking at me, so I'm actually okay with that. Let's go up here to the top one, and let's talk about these Slithar? Yeah, Slithar. 227 HP, 342 experience, 78 gold apiece, possibly will drop moon robes, which is just like an armor for the girls. They are red, so they take extra damage from purple. Unfortunately, Lambda Burst will not do much to them because they're red. So for this first round, we are actually not going to do that. I will thin the herd a bit, though. Everyone is on purple, so I will take advantage of that. Yeah, we'll go here. Very good. Now, they weren't looking at us, which means that we got the first strike. So as soon as everyone's done taking their turn here, we'll be able to go right back into another set of turns with a lot of SP. So, let's see who goes next. Oh, and I forgot to show off their weapons.
Yeah.
You know what? I have a problem doing that sometimes. That's okay. In the next battle, we'll definitely see everybody's new weapon. You saw Cupel do the spike, so at least you could see that. And then you see everyone using their weapon. Actually, I'll do it right here, because I forgot that I get another turn. So we got a nice, cool thin blade this time for Vice. And it actually comes to a point on, like, the last sword that he had. And actually, what I'm going to do, I'm going to rain a sword, everybody. The yin wing is, you know, half of a yin yang symbol, and it's like, it's really cool. I like the way that it looks. It is like a yin yang, you know, the curvature and everything. And as you saw, she threw it in like a boomerang and came back to her. So I just think this is a really cool weapon. Guard, here I saw you. And then the Blade of Slumber. I think the blade itself looks the same from his other one, but this one has like some type of writing on it, and I don't know what the like Arcadian, like, you know, alphabet is or whatever, but, and it has to do probably with something that has, with, like, sleep. But we're gonna guard again. Yeah, we'll show off Ray of Swords. I like this move. Might as well.
Ray of Swords!
And everybody goes dead. And there we go.
That was fun!
Alright, perfect. Like it. Love it. Doing it again. And again and again and again, because there's a lot of enemies here. And I got a moon rope. Isn't that amazing? Anyway, as I was saying, if you look down here, you can actually see, like, holes in the wall. So you have one, two, there, and then there's one up top. So there's at least three more switches, and, you know, perfectly enough, there are three doors in front of us. Let's start with going over this way. You can tackle these in any order. It really doesn't matter. The room's still going to fill up in the same, like, you know, way every time. So it's really all of your own personal reference. Okay, so what we have here is a room that has a lot of pools in them. And if you go over to, like, one of the pools, you can kind of look down it, and you can see, you know, it looks like there's some place that you can stand on. So, just for the sake of it, let's get into a battle first. Hopefully with some new enemies as well, because that would just make it... Okay, cool, two new enemies, perfect, just as I like it to happen. We're going to start off with the Go Looper here, because this is the guy that actually appears out in the Afutoman airspace, and I chose to skip talking about him when I was looking for discoveries, because, you know, time. This guy has 82 HP, give you 1,139 experience, 789 gold, possibly dropped black maps and Dexa seeds and all that other good stuff. Problem with Go Looper, besides it being a looper and like high, you know, evasion and running away and everything, they love to put your characters to sleep, so be careful with that. Too many of these guys, and it could be a very long, drawn-out, annoying battle. Right below them is the Krylabeast. 355 HP, 470 experience, 133 gold, possibly drop Sylph Seeds because everything is about speed for them, they cast Quicka and everything. They're green, so a Lambda Burst will take them out very easily. And actually, in this particular situation, I'm going to attack you. We will land the verse. Do it again, and do it again. Let's see here. They are also faster than your party members. So, oh man, jeez. So, if you happen to catch them in a, like a preemptive strike, and you decide, well, I'm just going to skip my turn since my next turn I have full SP and go crazy on them, they will still move before your guys, and they like to run away. So... Just kind of keep that in mind as you go through. Oh, sweet. Put him to sleep. Nice. That's what I like to see. Good job, Enrique. Not that this is going to matter. They would all go down with a Lambda Burst, so it is a really good method to use. Just
that was easy.
Kind of like, you know, didn't really matter in this particular fight. All right. Get some experience. Fina, I think, is on her last point for purple magic, so I'm just going to keep on purple until she learns it. But anyway, say you wanted to go down this one. You go here, you touch the water, you put on your scuba suit, and you jump on down, and then you look around and you realize that wherever you are is not where you want to be. This is actually a really obnoxious area. What you want to do is you want to be able to try to figure out where that hole is. This way you can land on that platform, walk up and around, and back there in the corner is actually where the switch is. Jeez, where is it? You can only, there we go, you can only get down from these places, from these, like, platforms right here that, slope downward. So we hop on down. God, everything is just so slow! Oi! And I need to find the exit, which should be right here, very good. And then we can just walk ourselves out of here. It's actually a fairly long path in order to get out, and the just slow maneuvering of Vice while he's underwater is so, like... I remember watching a thing on YouTube, Top 10 Worst Water Levels. I think Screw Attack did it, and this was actually one of their top 10. Probably because of the fact that when you are running around under the water, it's just so obnoxious just to try to get from point A to point B. And this room, if you do not know where you're going, can be, like, really tough. Like, you're always jumping into the wrong spot and everything. But where do you want to go? So, from the entrance, you're just going to pretty much go straight back, and you're going to go to this first one right here to the left. This should drop me where I need to be, and if I can see correctly from the map, I'm pretty sure this is it, right? Yes, perfect, excellent. So there you go, that's where you have to drop down in order to be able to get to where you need to get to. Otherwise that, it's a guess and check method, like, will this work? Maybe, jump down, check, yeah, and then, you know, over and over again. All right, pushing button. And it always starts, I believe, from the lower one regardless, so the second set of water comes out and fills up the room, which is good. Excellent. And now we get to move on to the next little switch thing. Spin this around. There we go. Oh man, could you imagine if there were, like, random encounters under the water? Oh my god, that would just be terrible. That would be horrible. oh, you move so slow as it is, and the encounter rate, I don't even care if the white map's on. Like, I was, like, flying around Yafutoma a few episodes ago looking for discoveries with the white map on, and I was still getting into quite a number of battles. It's like a normal RPG encounter rate with the white map. Otherwise, it's the Skies of Arcadia encounter rate, which is way more frequent than it should be. Alright, let's go. Come on. Whoop. Whoop. Luckily, this is the only area of the game you really have to do this. There are other underwater areas that you have to walk through, but this is, like, the only, like, long hallways that you have to slowly hop through. Like a moonwalk, you know? No gravity or whatever. I mean, very little weight on you, so you can, like, bounce around. There we go. Okay. It'd been really cool if Vice could jump. Okay, so the Slitharrs, the Krylobeast, and the Blue Loopers are kind of like your main enemies for the majority of this dungeon. These rooms, this is all you're going to run into, but there is another room where you're going to start running into two other enemies, and then there's one specific room that has a very specific enemy attached to it. So overall, this really isn't a bad place to do grinding. I mean, you get a good amount of money going through this place. That's a little bit off because I sold some stuff before coming into the dungeon, but you still get a good amount of money between the loopers that you find and the, like, sheer volume of enemies. Plus, you're able to build up your characters if you think they're too low of levels. Now, in terms of spirit, gaining, can I actually see everyone's, like, no, they actually don't tell me, show me SP. Vice gets 3, Ika, Fina, and Enrique all get 2. Ika gets her next SP at 38. I'm sorry, 36. She gets it at 36. Fina gets it at 38, and Enrique gets it at 32. So they're all very close to being able to get a third SP into the mix. If you wanted to run around here and, you know, grind up that way in order to get them, it's not a bad idea. But otherwise, I would say mid-30s is really, like, an ideal place. I also got a Moonberry from that encounter. So what I'm going to do is I actually have 8 of them right now, and I'd like to kind of start giving everyone a little bit more power. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to give Ika her final special move. Summons the power of the Red Moon to destroy all the enemies on screen using the Omega Cyclone. Unfortunately, you would think that Omega Cyclone is just a better Lambda Burst, and in all retrospect, it is, but it isn't. It doesn't do that much more damage, and it's like 4 more SP, so due to the fact that the damage ratio is so off, I usually stick with Lambda Burst regardless throughout the course of the game. Fina, however, her very last one, revives, cures all adverse effects, and completely restores all HP of all allies. Lunar Light. This is basically an invulnerability away from being Great Gospel from Final Fantasy VII. This move also takes priority in a battle, so if everybody else is dead except for Fina, and you have enough SP to cast Lunar Light, she basically pushes the big reset button on everything, and everyone's alive, and everyone's cured, and everyone's fully healed, and you can then go ahead and beat the crap out of things. So, just another big reason why Fina being alive is extremely important. I would need 4 in order to give Enrique his last one, and we'll get it eventually, but for right now, I just wanted to do that because I had the Moonberries, and I was like, eh, why not? Alright, so, next room. This one's much easier to deal with than the last one. All you gotta do is come down this way, go up the ramp right here, and as you can see, we get into a battle. What actually I was gonna point out were... Nope, I can't. Can I not go into... There we go. I was going to point out that those odd colored blocks that are there on the ground, basically those will rise up when this room is filled with water, and the switch to do that is right here. So we push this button, it glows all bluey, glowy-ish, whatever. Fills the room up with water, raises the blocks up, so now we have a bridge in order to get to the switch we need to get to, and it's a little bit easier of a walk back because we'll be underwater through most of it. It appears that this switch was here to fill this area with water. Very good, Vice. Way to be observant. Many, many thumbs up to you, my friend. Okay, let's go this way. I'm also pretty sure that even though Mount Kazaya is based off of Mount Fuji, pretty sure the actual Mount Fuji doesn't have all of these, you know, puzzles and everything in it. I mean, if anything, it's housing Godzilla, but that's really about all I can think of. All right, so across the bridge to the button, push, do the little water glow thing right there, and the second of the holes starts filling up with water. There we go. So you really get a sense on what the blue moon crystal is all about here, and that would be the ships themselves harness the power of wind to be able to go up super high in the atmosphere, while here in the mountain, it's the harnessing of the water. It's another reason why I like the Wevlam spells, because it like combines the two elements together. You get like a drop of water that comes down, and then a wind blast that like makes it explode like a miniature bomb. Like, it's crazy. You heard me get close to the moonfish over there. There's no way you can get to it yet, so you'll just hear it, walk by it, and you just gotta keep moving. What's over here, though, is a really cool path and a battle, which might actually have some new enemies in it. We've reached an area of the map that should have... Yeah, we go. Okay, thought so. So, one of the two new enemies within this one section is the Mantoid. We have seen these before. A lot of these are just recolored of guys. Even the Slithers were... We saw them in the... The Temple of Pyrrhon, and they were red. So, it's just recoloring. The Mantoid here, though, has 1,722 HP, 940 experience, 366 gold, could possibly give you a Zale Seed, and they like to cast as Pyrum spells. They have a terrible bite, which is one of their attacks, and generally speaking, you just want to take them down. Which, this battle is going to be a little bit more annoying, because not only do I have to take it down, which it has a lot of HP, but I got to take down these Slithars as well.
Here goes!
And I think the only one out of my team is Fina that wouldn't be able to kill it in one shot. Let's find out.
Over there.
No, I stand corrected. Good job, Fina. Way to use the people spear. People spearhead. Oddly enough, this isn't going to kill that thing either. So close. So when I say this thing has like a terrible bite, that's like one of its special techniques that it does. It'll literally like grab one of your characters, bite them, and fling them around. It's a really cool animation, but it doesn't do much of anything. The worst thing you gotta deal with those guys is they do have the ability to fatigue a character, which means they will not be able to gain any SP while they're fatigued. And this is a very high level fire spell, and it looked more impressive than it actually was. All out attack. Oh, you guarded this round. Ah, you little slithery jerk. There you go. Down you go. Oi.
That was easy.
Yep, we did good. Good job, Vice. All right, more, more, more. See, everyone's actually really close to a level up, so very excited about that. And we're going to continue on. So there's our first chest of the area. We can't get it yet. But you gotta be careful. There's a lot of dead ends in this particular side of the cave. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna head... Yes, we're gonna head down this way. Gonna go into here. And while we're down here, we actually have a few different options. To get to the switch, you wanna go that way. But, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Turn around, go kind of back the way you came underneath. And this is the way to get to that chest that's all the way down this way. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to slow walk myself all the way over there until I get it. Come on. There we go. All right. So this is good. Good, good, good. And then you're going to go ahead and you're going to see the ramp leading upwards as soon as you get up and around these, like, you know, pillars that are sticking up out of the water. There we go. And our first chest of two actually contains a little bit of a surprise! I mean, of course, you would have to expect a Zivlin Bane to be in Mount Kazai. I mean, there's so many good things for him to take that he has to be able to collect something for his lord and bring it back. So we are here to stop him and take the treasure that is within the chest. This particular Zivlin Bane has 5,144 HP, 3,415 experience, 4,738 gold. As always, he's able to drop a variety of seeds. He is red, so you want to use purple, which is good because that's what everyone is. So let's go ahead and start beating him up. do that. We're going to do that. I do not. I don't have my last spell. It sucks. But that's okay. We'll use this. And Enrique can do that. I mean, he has a lot of health compared to other Zivalins that we fought before. So this may take a little bit of time, but I should be able to beat him before the end of the episode. Hopefully this will do a good amount of damage. Come on. Big, big icicle blast. There we go. Come on, come on, come on. Ooh, 628. Good job, Fina. Awesome. Oh, good. He didn't burst. Oh, we countered too? Man, in one round, Fina did like 800-something damage. That never happens. Oh, Enrique, really? 271? I expected so much more from you. All right, so we can do this. We'll do a basic attack. We'll go ahead and... What? It is 8. Okay, all right. So we'll go ahead and we'll do Crystallis Box here, and then we'll Royal Blade. There we go. This should do a healthy amount of damage. There we are. Nice. That's 1. That's 2. Cast the spell.
Let's try this.
Good. The box didn't break. I was afraid that it might have, but that's all right. Still good. 407 damage. And Enrique does the Royal Blade. Slice and dice. Very. Wait, are you dead? Okay, good. I thought he had a sliver of health left.
That was easy.
And there we are. Another Zivalin Bane defeated. We get the spoils of war with all the experience and gold. Very good. And we got a magazine. Cool. I'll take it. And the chest that he was guarding is the Wind Song Orb. Just kind of another item that you can bring into any shop and sell for a profit, because, you know, never have too much gold in this game, especially for the later stuff. So I'm going to jump back into the water, and I will meet you when I get back to the one area. It's just so slow. All right, coming out of the tunnel right there, you just want to go straight back to up here, if I don't get stuck on a wall for no apparent reason. And I want to say it's to the right. To the left would be... Nope, I was wrong. That was a dead end. It's to your left. I went right and then the next one was left. So up here... Ah, terrible bite. Oh, what a terrible bite that was. And it actually causes fatigue, which really, really sucks. Oh, come on. Really? That's the... Man, both Fina and... not Fina. Both Ika and Vice are fatigued right now, which really stinks, but it doesn't really matter because we beat it anyway.
We did it!
I just wanted to show off Terrible Bite, because again, it was a really cool animation, and as you saw, it fatigued your character, which sucks, but it was still cool to watch. And everybody... Well, two people leveled up, which I believe now they are... Enrique is one level away from an SP, and Ika is two levels, so that's good. Hopefully I'll be able to get a little bit more ahead of it. But, as I was saying, if you go up and over here... Oh, God! Seriously, I was doing so well with this dungeon, and now all of a sudden, the monster just won't leave me alone. So ridiculous. Okay, so here is the button behind the waterfall. Let's go ahead and push it. And then that will cause the final area to fill up with water, and thus enable us to jump down the pit in order to be able to get where we need to go. And I am actually going to stop it right there. I will meet you guys back at the pit, you know, in front of it, you know, in the next episode. But until then, thank you all for watching. Be sure to like and comment down below. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button so you can get equipped with me, MetalBlade427. In the next episode, we continue our journey through Mount Kazai, the water dungeon of Skies of Arcadia, until we reach the area where we need to go to find the Blue Moon Crystal. You guys have a good one, and I will catch you all later.